Hospital area. We are in the area of the abandoned timber mill and the dairy farm, and this is where the patients would go to do some extracurricular activities. Okay, so this is where they held some of the cattle. You have a little cattle places. All right. So the patients who are functional at the asylum would spend their days working in a place like this. They could farm, help raise cattle. They would work at one of the lumber mills, which is right up, like across the compound over there. There's also a bakery and a few factories that they could work at. Recreational activities were also offered for the ones who could do that, so they had like board games and things like that.
They opened because of overflow at hospitals, and this place was put to take in the overflow patients that were actually not as mentally ill as some people might think that would go to an insane asylum. They were usually just suffering from short-term episodes, and by the end of their time here, they were actually insane. It was shut down in 1955 due to lots of inhumane acts of curing these mental illnesses, such as electroshock therapy and lobotomies that went wrong.
Okay, so the Northern State Mental Hospital was commissioned in 1909 and was opened 2 years later in 1911. The original goal was for it to be a self-sustaining colony for the mentally ill. It got decked out with 700 acres of farmland and a bunch of other things. This is one of the buildings that they used for dairy farming.
So after World War II, a lot of Nazis fled here from their country to work in the United States. And even though they didn't have proper medical license, they were still able to get hired at mental institutions.
So this building is where they had horses. Take a look in there. There are little stables for them. And then in that building over there, they had cattle. Okay, so here at the institution, there are about 1,487 bodies buried throughout the 700 acres of land. Many of them were not claimed by their families, so their bodies were left to the state and they don't know who they are. In comparison, at maximum capacity, the institution held 2,700 people, and they were only open for 42 years, so that is a lot of deaths. So those patients that did get claimed by their families were buried here. They had headstones, but there's been so much erosion and flooding that all the headstones that were there are now gone. So it's just an open field.
With a hasty word you can recall.